Morning students, I welcome you for this today's session and I hope I finished that problems, all the problems in the exercise 11.5 in my previous class and I completed the chapter also. But anyway, in this session I'm going to revise that which are the problems I left and which are the problems are important for exercise 11.1, 11.2 likewise. Okay, so overall I'm going to revise that problems and concepts. So please who are all not seeing that video properly, so just please take a note and just note that major concept. Okay, so please try to understand and take your book and just note it. Okay, so thank you all. So just see this today's session and some problems I left for that one for your reference. Okay students, today I'm going to revise that concepts of algebra. Okay, so we are going to prepare for your PA2 exam. So PA2 exam, for that I'm going to revise the chapters which are the things I taught. Okay, so the first one in that algebra, so you know that in algebra what I said first, so first one in that algebra, so mainly it is representing that two things. So one is that constant, it's a combination of constant and variable. Okay, constant and variable. Okay, first one, what is mean by constant? So constant means, see, this is a revision video students, so please see that one, then only you can understand. So constant, so constant means we can say the value will not change, value is not changing. Okay, value is not changing. That means we can represent the number, we can represent the constant in terms of numbers. So for example, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, so likewise we can represent constant. And mainly you have to know that this is the known value. Okay, constant, which means known value. Okay, and what about the variable? What is mean by variable? So variable means this is called unknown value. So what is that variable? So variable means unknown value. So we can represent this variable in terms of letters. Okay, so we can use the letters, like for example x, y, z, so this kind of we can use, or even p, q, r, so this kind of letters we can use for instead of denoting that variable. Okay, and the value is not a constant value here. The variable, it keeps on changing that one. Okay, so we can say this is called variable. Okay, so next one in that first exercise, what are the things we did? So matchstick pattern, am I right? So matchstick pattern. Okay, in that matchstick pattern, what I said, for example, you are going to make the letter of any alphabet which is present in English by using matchsticks. Let us consider that L. Okay, so for that L, I required two matchsticks. Am I right? For making one L, I need two matchsticks. For making two L, how many matchsticks I required? So that means four matchsticks I required. Okay, so for making two L, for making a single L. Okay, so first one you have to notice this one. What is the thing is, for making one letter, how many matchsticks? Two matchsticks are needed. Okay, so for making two L means four matchsticks are needed. For making three L means, so you need 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 matchsticks are needed. So there is a pattern is occurring. For example, 3 match 3 L letter L, four letter, five letters, that means 5L. 5L if you are making means 6L, 7L, 8L. So likewise, if it is going on continuously means, so we have to know one pattern. So how to analyze the pattern means, for a single letter L, how many matchsticks are required? Two. So if it is going on continuously means that pattern is occurs N. We can say the pattern is 2N. Okay, so 2N which represent, see here, the pattern of that making pattern of making the matchstick L. Okay, the matchstick, the letter word L, making a letter L. Okay, so if you have taken N value starting from 1, 2, 3 means just replacing that 1, 2N means 2, that means for one letter. So 2, 2 means 4, that is for 2L, that is 3 if you put means 6, that is making for 3L. So likewise, they arranged some patterns. So this one we did that one, okay, and then we said that idea of that variable. So the idea of the variable means how to represent in terms of variable, that is called 2N. Okay, so more matchstick pattern means, for example, I'm using the word W. Okay, so 1 2 3 4 matchstick needed. So for one W, if I have to make means, four matchsticks are needed. If I'm going to make N number of letter means, I have to write 4N. So N value here I have mentioned starting from 1 2 3, likewise, so 4 into 1 4, which is for one matchstick, and that means one word, one letter W. Okay, so for two, if you put means, for making two letters, the W letter. So this kind of pattern we gets arranged. Okay, so the next one is called more example of variables. Okay, so more examples on variables means they gave some conditions. Okay, for that condition we have to identify what is the pattern. For example, I will revise that in that exercise 11.1. so in that exercise 11.1, for example, third problem. So the exercise 11.1 third problem means, cadets are marching in a parade, there are 5 cadets in a row, and what is the rule which gives the number of cadets given the number of rows? So the number of rows, for one row 1 2 3 4 5, so 5 persons are there for one row. If it is like n number of rows, if it is going at n number of rows means, so how can we make a pattern? So that means we have to use 5N. So 5N is the correct answer. Okay, so here N denotes that number of arrangements, number of rows. So if you put 1 means we can find that first row, and if you put N equal to 2 means we can find the second rows. Okay, so these are the thing so far I said, and one more example I am going to revise that. So fourth one, if there are 50 mangoes in a box, how will you write the total number of mangoes in terms of the box? Okay, if there are 50 mangoes in a box, so 50 mangoes which is present, so mangoes, number of mangoes, 50 mangoes. So 50 mangoes are present in one box. That means how will you write the total number of mangoes in terms of number of box? So number of box means lot of boxes present, n number of boxes present. So for one box 50 mangoes means n number of box means we can write 50N. Okay, so here N we have to take starting from 1 2 3, so likewise we have to take. Okay students, understood? Okay, and then what are the things we have seen? So use a variable in common rules. So use of variables in common rules. Okay, use of variable in common rules. For example, from under that we have seen that for square, if they said to length L, here also L, here also L means, what is the thing is, what is the perimeter of that square? So perimeter, we can say there are totally four sides, 1 2 3 4 sides, and for one side they given value L, that means 4L. Okay, so this kind of we can derived that one. And perimeter of rectangle also we have seen. Perimeter of rectangle means for example, so this one L, this one B, and this one also B, this one also L, which means that so how many length are present? So 2 times the length is present, 2 times the breadth is present. So take 2 common outside, so 2 into L plus B, which is the perimeter. So this is equal to perimeter of the rectangle. Okay, so these are the things we have seen. Okay, the next one, what is the thing is commutative properties. Okay, so commutative properties under addition and multiplication. So commutative properties means what is the thing is, even though if you are adding the two number, for example 2 plus 4 which is equal to 4 plus 2, am I right? So that means even if you are changing that value or alterating that values, the total sum will not be changed. So 2 plus 4 equal to 6, 4 plus 2 also 6. So that means if we have taken any variables a plus b which is equal to b plus a, that is the called commutative property under addition. Okay, and what's the property of commutative property under multiplication? So same number, if you have taken 2 into 4, so 4 into 2. So if you multiplied this and this means same value you are getting. That means the commutative property means if you are interchanging the numbers, the total value will not be changed. So 2 into 4, 4 into 2, both also same value only. Okay, students. So the next one is distributive property. So distributive property means you have to know that distributive property. Okay, so distributive property means I will take one number, see here a into b plus c. Okay, so a into b plus c means first a into b and here one plus is there, that plus you have to write, and a into c. Okay students, so a into b plus a into c. So here a, b, c, that is represent the variable. So instead of that variable I am going to give some value also. Okay, so first you have to know that for example 7 into 12. So I can multiply this way, otherwise I will write 7 into, so 12 I can split as 10 plus 2. Okay, so 10 plus 2 means this is a, this is b, this is c. Okay, so a equal to 7, b equal to 10, and c equal to 2. So how can we write in terms of distributive property means take this number and distribute it, this one 7 into 10, first one 7 into 10, and then plus, so plus 7 into 2, so 7 into 2, so 7 into 10 70 plus 7 into 2 14, that is equal to 84. Okay, so this is called distribution. Okay, we have to distribute that one. So a multiplication over addition, the distributive property, multiplication over addition, this is the thing. Okay, so the next one is actually that 11.2 some exercise problem we did. Okay, for example the 11.2 first problem, so what they given, the side of an equilateral triangle is shown by L, so express the perimeter of the equilateral triangle L. So see here, you have to know triangle, there are three sides, so the side of that triangle is L, they said L. So what is the perimeter we have to find in terms of L means, so first you have to know perimeter, which is equal to number of sides, see here 1 2 3, so number of sides 3 totally, and for each side value, so one side value means so everyone constant, so that means L, so that means P equal to 3L. Okay, so this kind of we have to identify the concept. Even that what is the call is next problem also they give, second problem. So second problem, what they given, the side of the regular hexagon is denoted by L. So hexagon, so which means that six sides, see here, this is the called hexagon 1 2 3 and 4 5 6. Okay, so this is called a hexagon. Okay, so I will name it as A and B, C, D, D, E and F. Okay, so here they gave the side of your regular hexagon is denoted by L. So denoted by L. Okay, so just denote it as L, L, L. So what is the perimeter of that one? What is the perimeter of that one means? So we have to write first perimeter, which is equal to number of sides. Totally number of sides is 6 sides. For one side value they given L, that means 6L. Okay students, understood? Okay. Okay, the next problem they given even the diameter in terms of